In this example, we are given that the radius of tangent galvanometer is 16 cm and we are required to find the number of turns in its coil if a current of 40 milliampere is required to produce deflection of 30 degree in it from magnetic meridian. And we are also given with the horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field at this point, which is 36 microtesla. Now, in this situation, as we know that in a tangent galvanometer, we already studied that the magnetic field due to the coil we can write as BH tan theta if theta is the angle of deflection of magnetic needle from magnetic meridian. Like if this is magnetic meridian in which the coil is initially located, which is the direction of horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field. When a current flows through the coil, a magnetic induction BC, which is due to the coil, is also developed and in the direction of resultant, now the coil will point. If this angle is theta, here we can write the value of tan theta is equals to BC over BH. And we know the value of magnetic induction due to coil is given as mu naught Ni by 2R, which is equals to BH tan theta. And rearranging these terms, we can directly get the number of turns in the coil of tangent galvanometer, which is given as 2RBH tan theta divided by mu naught I. If we substitute the values, we can get the value of number of turns. It is 2 multiplied by the radius is 0.16 and horizontal component of Earth's field is 36 into 10 to power minus 6 tesla. As theta is given as 30 degree, tan 30 degree, I can substitute as 1 by root 3 divided by, if I substitute the value of mu naught, it is 4 pi into 10 to power minus 7 multiplied by the current which is given at 40 milliampere, this is 40 into 10 to power minus 3. If we simplify this, finally we are getting the result as 0.0132 into 10 to power 4, which is equals to 132 turns in the coil. That will be the answer to this problem.